former COMELEC Commissioner Rowena Guanzon is gunning for a seat in the House as Pamilya Pasyente at Persons with Disabilities or P3PWD party list.
Let's get to know the party's plans in the Congress if they win a seat. We have P3PWD first nominee Rowena Guanzon via Zoom joining us today. Good morning po. Thanks for joining us
good
today.
Good morning po. Good morning po. Thanks for inviting me. We are very hopeful we will win a seat because we already won 391,000 votes last time. It's just that there's a Supreme Court case that where the speaker deemed it best not to include me to assume office. So these are our programs. We want generally rights, welfare, benefits for persons with disability and senior citizens because they're probably going to be PWDs. So specifically, higher income tax deduction for households which have persons with disability. For example, OFW kayo, mataas yung income tax nyo. Kailangan mas mataas yung deduction nyo dahil may PWD kayo sa bahay, lalo na yung mga bata. Mm-hmm. Yung mga senior citizens po, isama na lang din natin dito. Mm-hmm. Number two, yung social pension na monthly ng mga persons with disability, lalo na po yung mga nakahiga or homebound, di ba? Number three, idoble na sa 1 billion ang sped budget dahil yung mga bata po na may special needs, learning disabilities, napakarami na. At ngayon, ang budget is only at 500,000. Number four, yung PhilHealth po na yan, kailangan po mag-expand talaga sila ng services nila at saka coverage. Kasi laki naman pala ng 89 billion na yan. Ba't nyo pa isusoli yan sa National Treasury para gawin yung mga bridge dyan at mga kung ano-ano infrastructure. Ibigay nyo yan sa amin kasi maraming PWD, kailangan dialysis, cancer patients, may limit. Yung mga batang cerebral palsy, bakit hindi nyo mabigyan ng mga specialized na wheelchair? Hirap kaya ng 40,000 each yun. That should be covered also. It's not their fault na cerebral palsy. Nagbabayad naman kami ng premium, hindi po ba? So the other things are yung sa local government code. I have a book on the local government book as a textbook in the UP College of Law. I want to file a bill to amend the local government code and also, or as a special law, provide that 5% of the total IRA or total budget of local government units, government agencies, and government-owned and controlled corporations should be allocated and dedicated and spent for persons with disability. The other thing is the percentage of workers or employees in every government agency or private sector. You increase it to maybe 10% of their total number of employees, but not less than two. You don't have to be standing up when you're doing the books. You don't have to stand up when you're answering phone calls. So on a minimum of two, businesses that will hire will comply with this 10% of their workers should get a tax incentive also as a sort of tax exemption.
Opo.
Yes.
Go
ahead, ma'am.
So you want to ask questions?
Yes.
Can I finish?
Go ahead, Angel.
Go ahead po. We were asking lang po nung nakita po natin yung mga plans nyo po when it comes to health and other education para po sa mga PWD natin. Mm-hmm. Pagdating naman po sa employment, kasi we've seen a lot of news and reports, studies about it na meron pa rin po mga diskriminasyon pagdating po sa trabaho, no? What are you going to do po?
Right now, there are 1.6 to 2 million Filipinos that are unemployed. Now, how many of those are actually PWDs who have college degrees, who are trained or skilled? The problem with fighting for a slot in employment, if there's a high unemployment rate in the country, is that they always hire the PWDs last. Mm. They hire the men first because they don't get pregnant. They don't like the women because they get pregnant and they have, they get sick, So,
maternity
but
leave.
last of all is their PWD who had to compete in the labor market. Yeah. That's why we want a law that will say at least 10% of your workers, government and private sectors, should be persons with disability who are equally qualified. And we want to be able to appeal the decision of every government agency that denies our applicants. We want to be able to appeal it to the Civil Service Commission. And the other thing is, it's not just that. It's the economy, you know. In an economy where almost 2 million are unemployed and where, you know, the budget goes to these unnecessary confidential funds, the PWDs always lose out in the end. You see, that's the trouble. Kaya walang focus sa pagbibigay ng karapatan, ng equality. Kasi akala nila yung mga PWD hindi naman nagbabayad ng tax yan. Eh kami naman nagbabayad kami ng tax, di ba? Kasangga nila kami, nagbabayad kami ng tax eh. Gusto namin yung tax namin mapunta rin sa mga karapatan nila at services nila.
You mentioned equality, ma'am, no? There was a survey, recent surveys that show ang pinakahinaing po ng mga ibang PWD daw is as simple as hanggang ngayon, kahit may mga laws or local codes, hindi pa rin daw sinusunod ng mga establishments, ang access to these establishments na basic ramps na kakasya, ang wheelchair, proper incline.
Gusto namin talaga, make it criminal. Like, make the president of the company account for it. We will file criminal cases if there is if the law provides. We will file. We have volunteer lawyers just to make sure that they comply, even government agencies. It should be criminal not to comply with these laws on accessibility. You know, in other countries like Japan, meron silang tiles eh sa mga kalye nila, daanan nila, yes, sa subway, where the blind can see, you know, by the texture of the tiles kung saan papunta yung sa subway ba yan, papunta ba ito ng market, sa bus stop, ganyan. Eh dito eh, simpleng bagay eh, hindi magawa. At hindi pa matutulungan dahil yung MRT, wala namang umaandar na mga escalator or elevator. I mean, the government is just making it, you know, 10 times harder for persons with disability and old people to live a decent life here in the Philippines. So what's the problem? The problem is corruption. The problem is corruption. If you have zero corruption, then that money should go where it should go. It should go to the people who need it the most and to generate, promote development in the economy. How can you have, how can you invite investors here, generate new jobs, if you have a very high rate of corruption? Bakit ko siya anti-abroad? Bakit ko naman dadaling dito? Eh, daling ko na lang sa Vietnam, daling ko na lang sa Indonesia, where there's a lesser, they have corruption also, but lower. Walang tatalo dito sa Pilipinas, pakakawatan ng mga government officials na yan. Pakakawatan ngayon, hindi na kayo nahiya. Saka yung mga contractor na nagpa-party list, ha? Ito, ulitin ko to sa House when I sit in a privileged speech. Kayo mga contractor kayo, you are buying for party list seats, hindi na kayo nahihiya na gumagana kayo, giginansya kayo sa mga projects gusto nyo pa, kayo mismo ang congressman? Aba, yung masama.
Sino po ba yan?
That's against the constitution and what you're doing is criminal.
Oo. You have someone in mind po na sinasabihan nyo po?
Hindi na kami magtotoo sa House at kailangan ay lambingin nila ako dahil babartugulan ko sila.
Apo. Taking this opportunity na rin po to ask you regarding yung malaking issue po, no, pagkausapin po ng eleksyon, itong political dynasty. Marami po ngayon na tumatakbo sa pagiging party list, sa Senate. Your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I already said that in the COMELEC interview, that I will file a bill to end political dynasties, lalo na po sa party list. Sila na ang congressman, sila pa rin ang party list. Na ba kayo dyan? Wala na kayong makuha ng trabaho? Hindi naman kayo ganyan kabobo, ah. Nag-aaral naman kayo. Kayo na ang congressman, i-double back-to-back dyan pa vote buying nyo? Para mas mura, buy one, take one? Ba't talaga mo yung mga tao, eh? Yan, mga sakit ang loob ko kasi. At my age, akala ko makikita ko na talaga demokrasya ito. Eh, look at this. Now I have to live another 30 years para makita ko. Ang totoong demokrasya na ito. Pero, at sinasabi ko yung dynasty bill na yan, matagal na yan dapat. lahat naman kasi nakaupo dyan, eh may ganan siya sa dynasty. Hindi personal to, dami ko friends dyan ha. Dami ko friends dyan ha. In fact, they're helping our people, PWDs ha. Pero tama na. Pag nakapasa tayo ng ganyan, mag-support na kayo. At yung mga anak nyo nang walang trabaho, bigyan nyo yan ng negosyo.
Ito, ma'am,
speaking of support po.
Ito, ma'am, speaking of support, at saka sinasabi ng marami, isa pang dynasty to, pag nanalo daw kayo, ano ang gagawin nyo pag may possible impeachment complaint laban kay VP Sara?
Will you support it or not?
Bakit mo yan i-impeach? Kailangan may betrayal of public trust? Depende sa complaint. Ano ako, tanga? Hindi ako oto-oto. I am the top 10 in my class in UP. I was a law professor. I wrote 10 books. I have a Harvard degree. My father, summa cum laude. I am not oto-oto. Hindi ako sasama sa alon. I will not go along just to get along. You show me a complaint and you show me the evidence and I will be the judge of that.
On that
note, ayoko ng stance niya na pro-China sila. Kahit ako, anti-China to ka talaga. I want to stand on our sovereignty and the arbitral ruling. And that is one good thing, the only one good thing that President BBM has done that I can see. He is standing up for the arbitral ruling and that the occupation of China of our West Philippine Sea must stop now.
Oh, yan nga po yung lamang sa survey kanina pinag-uusapan natin namin ni Diego dito yung mga lamang po sa mga Pilipino natin, gusto nila ng mga kandidato na papabor po dun sa pagtatanggol ng ating soberanya. Pero marami pa po kaming gustong itanong sa inyo. Unfortunately, we don't have much time. Sana po sa susunod mas maimbita po namin kayo na mas maaga para mas marami po tayo mapag-usapan. Maraming salamat po sa inyo.
Bago pong barong ko eh.
Maganda po. Bagay po sa inyo.
Maganda po.
Sa susunod po dito kayo sa studio.
Laban lang mga anak, mamabing nyo. Kaya pa. Kaya pa ng tuhod at puso at isip. Laban lang.
Thank you so much, P3, PWD, first nominee, Rowena Guanzon.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.